हाय फ्रेंड्स, आई एम रजनीकांत। वेलकम यू टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल सुमंत डिजिटल इंग्लिश ट्यूटोरियल वीडियोस। डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिक्टेट फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द लेसन लैंडस्केप ऑफ द सोल, इंग्लिश 11th क्लास हॉर्नबिल। Question 1. Briefly narrate the story of emperor and the Chinese artist. Its answer. A painter, Mu Daozi, who lived in 18th century, was asked to paint a landscape by the Tang emperor Xuanzang to decorate a palace wall. The artist concealed his work behind a screen so that only the emperor would see it. For a long time, the emperor admired the wonderful scene. One day, the painter showed him a cave at the foot of mountain and said that a spirit dwelt there. The painter clapped his hands and the entrance to the cave opened. He then entered the cave and the entrance closed behind him. Since then, nothing is known of the artist or the painting, as the painting vanished off the wall. Question 2. How did stories such as one about Mu Daozi play an important role in Chinese classical education? Its answer. Such stories played a significant part in China's classical education. They helped the master to guide his pupil in the right direction. They were not merely tales, but were deeply illuminating of the essence of art. The books of Confucius and Zhuangzi are full of such stories. They reveal that art was considered the essence of inner life and spirit in Asia. Question 3. Why did the artist agree to get his daughter married to the blacksmith? Its answer. Initially, the artist was against the blacksmith, Quinton Metsys, marrying his daughter. However, one day, Quinton's Lily sneaked into the painter's studio and painted a fly on his latest panel. That was so realistic that the master tried to sweat it away. The artist was so impressed that he admitted Quinton as an apprentice in his studio and let him marry his beloved. Question 4. What is the difference between the Chinese and European art? Its answer. The Chinese and European art are different, as the European art is trying to achieve a perfect illusionistic likeness in Europe, and the Chinese the essence of inner life and spirit in Asia. While the European wants you to look at the landscape through his eyes, the Chinese painter wants you to enter it from any point, then travel in it. He creates a path for your eyes to travel up and down and then back again in a leisurely movement. Question 5. How does the Sun Tzu express the deist view of the universe? Its answer. Sun Tzu means mountain water. It expresses the deist view. The mountain is young and it stretches vertically towards heaven. It is stable, warm and dry in the sun while the water is in. It is horizontal and resting on the earth, fluid, moist and cool. The interaction of in the receiver, feminine aspect of the universal energy, and yang, active and masculine, is the fundamental belief of deism. Question 6. What is lacking in Sansui? Its answer: the third element, the middle void, where their interaction takes place, is lacking in Sansui. The middle void is indispensable, hence nothing can happen without it. This is the reason why the white unpainted space in Chinese landscape is important. This is also where the man finds a fundamental role in what space between heaven and the earth. He becomes the medium of communication between both poles of the universe. Question 7. How is the pranayama compared to the middle void? Its answer: the middle void is vital and nothing can happen without it. This is the reason why the white unpainted space in Chinese landscape is imperative. This is also where the man finds fundamental role in the yogic practice of pranayama. We breathe in, retain and breathe out. The suspension of breath is the void where the meditation takes place or occurs. Question 8. How did the theory of brute art put towards by Jean Dubuffet get credence? Its answer: French painter Jean Dubuffet challenged the concept of art brute in the 1940s. Before that, the art of untrained visionary was of minor interest. At about the same time, an untutored genius was clearing a paradise. This was none other than Nekchen, who cleared a little patch of jungle to make himself a garden sculpted with the stone and recycled material known to the world today as the rock garden at Chandigarh. Dear guys, it was all for today. Hope you must have enjoyed this video lecture. Keep watching this video from top to toe. Thanks for watching. Bye.